ओके सर, यू कैन स्टार्ट।
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू दोस हैव जॉइंड फॉर दिस सेशन। आई होप यू आर डूइंग फाइन एंड सेफ। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑफ दिस वीक ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स लेक्चर बाय आवर फैकल्टी मोहम्मद सुबानी सर, लेट मी ट्राई टू गिव सम इंट्रो पार्ट और हिंट्स विच हेल्प्स यू टू प्रिपेयर योर सेल्फ फॉर द CAA 1 एग्जामिनेशन। एज यू अवेयर, the portion for the first CA is first unit alone, which means week number one, which consists of geometry construction, week number two, which comprises of like ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, and week three consists of cycloids, epi, hypo, and involutes. So all this will be considered for setting up the question paper for first CAA. I think the examination, which falls on Saturday between 2 and 4, right? It is almost 1.5 hour examination, I think so. 2 to 3:30, I think so. So the pattern for that, as you have already shared in WhatsApp group, the pattern is of 10 2-mark question for the part A and 2 15-mark question in part B without any choices. So in that case, you can easily predict what are the questions can be asked in part B, week one, which is of a very simple questions, right? It's an introduction part of geometry construction, interior angle based pentagon, hexagon, dividing the lines. So that and all is quite easier. So you also can predict that questions cannot be asked as a part B question from week one. The only possibility is week 2 and week 3 questions, which means curves and special curves or cycloids or involutes. So if you prepare well on this manual and you are practicing in the grid sheets, will obviously gives you back the required mark for the diagram what you are going to draw in your grid sheet. And next point is, if you are received your grid sheet, you are expected to draw only in the grid sheet, and you need to take the snap of it. And for the 2-mark questions, you can write it in a A4 sheet, and that A4 sheet also you can upload as a single file if that's possible, or multiple files, maximum 2 or 3 files. So restrict yourself in uploading that. So similarly to the assignment we have created for the uploading of weeks 1 to 5 grid sheet, we'll be creating the scheduled assessment where you will be receiving the question paper exactly at 2 o'clock on Saturday. So in that GCR, you can upload as you are doing for the AutoCAD exercises as well as for the grid sheet assignment as on date. You can follow the same procedure for uploading the grid sheets of for the first CA examination. And to the preparation of part A, as I have already quoted, week one questions are consist of only simple procedure and problems. So in general, the question setter may consider to ask some of the 2-mark question from that week one procedure. So I repeat once again, if any questions asked in part A on the construction based, that need to be only drawn in the grid sheet. For example, let us assume they asked to construct a interior angle based method of pentagon. That should not be drawn in A4 sheet. That should be only drawn or need to be drawn in the grid sheet alone. Except those people doesn't receive the grid sheet. So whoever received the grid sheet for the part A also, they should draw only in the grid sheet. So you plan accordingly before you start with the examination to draw in your grid sheet. So I could say some roughly 1 or 2 or maximum 3 questions in a different methods may be asked to draw in a part A based 2-mark question in the grid sheet. So that is the third important point. And fourth one is, hope you have received the textbook also with you for this engineering graphics subject. So in the first unit of coverage of syllabus, you try to go through all the contents which has been given in the textbook, right? Maybe few of things might be not covered by us in our discussion for the last like the first 3 weeks of class, but to the most we have covered like examples of types of lines, types of curves, types of pencil, how to make the lettering, why lettering is important. There are so many questions, right? So you try to go through all this, like probably it will be of some 10 to 15 pages of theory, like it will be of here and there. You just go through all this. If possible, better you take the notes if required. Just go through and keep it in your mind and try to recollect during the examination. So that's the third, fourth important point. And next important point is, similarly, you are trying out your AutoCAD exercises. So there might be some questions can be asked or might be asked in your examination of first CAA from AutoCAD part. So, but we are not sure of this. On my part and our class part, we are expecting such kind of question may also been arised, right, or been asked in your first CAA examination. Not much of a difficult question from AutoCAD, because you won't be allowed to do any works during the examination. So it is not required to have opening up your AutoCAD software and doing. So simply they may ask some tools like to erase a particular object, what kind of tool need to be used. For multiple creation of same objects, what kind of tool? We know array, polar array. So they may also ask what are different types of arrays are there, polar array, rectangular. So many types of arrays are there. So that we can mention. So these are some of the questions may ask, I repeat, may ask from AutoCAD part also. So on that, all these 5 points you try to cover your preparation and try to revise your preparation for the concern of engineering graphics first CA examination, right? If you have any doubt, you can ask by unmuting yourself or in the chat box. We both faculty are available to answer your queries. If not, maybe we wait for 2 more minutes for the students to ask the question. If not, Shivani sir will take over the session to proceed for the week six of exercises. Thank you, guys.
Satya sir, the time includes uploading the scanned.
Yeah, time. Yes, sir. It includes the uploading of time also, it seems. I think maximum 1.5 hour for the examination. Within half an hour, they need to upload, it seems.
Okay.
So 2 to 2:30, the examination. I already shared that in all the instructions also. So probably 2 to 3:30 examination time, and within half an hour after, they need to take the scan and converting to PDF and till to upload the answers.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Guys, if you have any doubts regarding CA, so please ask us.
And I give you 2 more minutes after this. I just wanted to, in the sense, we faculty insist again and again, be and behave like professionals, right? Don't try to like make us as a fools, right? We are not actually, and we know that you are also not one. So don't try to indulge yourself in any kind of malpractice, like sharing of your materials with others, or like sharing in the sense, you may, one of your friends or some of your friends may try to finish because of their involvement in the subject, they may try to finish the subject, finish the examination in an earlier mode. And I request such kind of students. I wish all the students should be like more interactive and more involved to a subject, in all subject of course. But such kind of students are not supposed to share their answer scripts or answers to others by the way of sharing in WhatsApp or email. I tell you that we can find it out who have shared it and who have received such kind of answers. during, not only during the upload, right? You people are not, I request, don't do such kind of any aspects of malpractice, even though it is well and good if you fail, right? It is only a matter of marks, not a matter of life, right? The attitude and your, I should not, like, I don't want to give so much of advice and all. Attitude and your responsibility is more important than your marks in your career, right? So don't lose your dignity in whatever the cases it is, right? So with that note, I stop my advising and all. Maybe if you have any questions, you come if you have come across in your mind, just open up your chat box or in unmuting by yourself. Yes, ma'am. Who's that?
Shaheen, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
For the CIA, the additional questions of week 2 are also there, right, sir?
No. So
you uploaded the video.
Exactly. So the week 2 additional problems I have separately recorded and uploaded for the knowledge purpose and for the on the emergency purpose, like. But people have confirmed that additional problems of week 2 will not be asked, right? So don't worry about the week 2 additional problems. Whereas week 3 additional problem, it's of involute. It's a very simple one, and we also solved in the regular classes of exercises. So don't worry about week 2 additional problems. Even though I have shared a separate video for that. Don't worry about that, and don't expect that the same questions will be asked like whatever we have solved in the class may again asked in the CA. Don't think that so, and don't think that not only to Fatima. I'm just addressing all the thanks for the question from Fatima. So I'm just addressing to all the people. So don't expect that the same question will be asked. And don't also think that whatever you have uploaded the GCR for the week's assignment can also be used for uploading the GCR. Don't think all such thoughts, right? Maybe the question look like the same, but you can expect the difference in the data. Maybe 40 diameter would be given as 50 diameter, 50 mm would be of 60 mm. So in that way, people try to differentiate the question. So I repeat, it is only to make yourself that you are following the subject and not to test a lot from your side. Everyone from top management to the faculty, everyone knows the situation of pandemic. So for that reason of pandemic, we are not making a very low delivering on the things, right? We in the sense also your side, I have many times insisted that you are the motivators for the faculty and management. So it is to test, I could say it's quite way of test, and you are following the subjects and not the gap between the subject and you is not that much far. For that purpose, people of faculty and management are handling or creating this kind of examination and all, and having this examination for you people. Right. I hope I have answered the much in depth of Fatima question, Sagin Fatima question. Any other question, guys? Deepan? Do you have any question, Deepan?
No, sir.
Thank you. Vocal? Tarun Kumar, I just randomly calling to ensure that everyone is understands the information. No, okay, Gokul, thank you, and Tarun Kumar. And maybe I make a question and answer the question by myself. What happened if I'm not attending the, if I not attend the CAA? Right? What happened if I not attend the CAA? Obviously, you know the answer is zero, right? Mark will be zero for the CAA. You try to maximum attend your examination without fail. Right? That would be the answer from our side. Okay, over to Shubhani sir for his instruction, if any.
Yes, sir, thank you, sir. I hope thank already you, given much more information.
Not only information, sir, yeah, lot of advice to do.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, thank you, guys. Do well, all the best. Shubhani, sir, you can take over the session, sir.
Okay, sir, thank you. Okay, good morning, guys. So, in this week, today, we'll solve or we'll be drawing the week 6 diagrams which is given in your manual. Okay. So, guys, are you able to see the PDF?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So, so this is week 6 problems, drawings given in the manual. That is construction of cylinder and cone by change of position method. So already in the last class, or the last week, we have seen the construction of prisms, pyramid by the change of position method. So this is regarding the prism and pyramids. Now we are going to see the cylinders and cone with the same procedure. Okay, so there is no change in the procedure in which we have drawn in the last week, but only the solid is going to be changed. Okay, only that. The first question is, draw the projection of a cylinder whose base is 30 mm diameter and axis is 40 mm long, resting with a point of its base on base circle on HP, such that the axis is making an angle of 30 degrees with HP and parallel to VP. Okay, so most of the all the drawings in the theory part itself we have discussed that we'll be taking in the first angle projection. It means that the object is placed in the solid is placed in the first quadrant. Okay. Okay, guys. See the first question is, first we'll take the, they have given the cylinder, so they ask us to draw the cylinder. So just for the understanding purpose, I will be drawing the simple position. Okay, so this is the center axis. So what they have given is the base is 30 mm diameter. So this base is 30 mm, right? And the axis 40 mm long. So this axis is 40 mm and resting with a point of its base on HP. So since this is the base of your cylinder, so if I take any point on the base, so let us take somewhere point here, it is point P. Now that is resting on the HP. So they didn't give us whether the axis is parallel, perpendicular to HP, or it is inclined. Now such that the axis is making an angle 30 degrees with HP. Now they have given that, so this axis is making theta 30 with HP. Okay. And it is also parallel to VP. So second condition is parallel to VP. So for understanding purpose, we will draw it on the quadrant. Okay. See, so this is the XY line. This is vertical plane. This is your HP, right? Now, so they told that any point on the face, it may lies on the HP. Okay, so it is not about, they have not given the position, so you can put it whatever. But the major condition is 30 degrees to HP and parallel to VP. And they have not mentioned the distance from the VP. So we can assume the whatever the value we want. Okay, but it should be offset from the VP. Okay. So I take that the axis is somewhere here. Okay. Now this is your HP plane. Now this is making an angle theta, that is 30 degrees, right, with HP. Now here your cylinder lies. Okay. Right. So this is how your, now the two conditions it satisfies. So one is the point P here. Okay. Here your point P lies on the HP and your axis makes 30 degrees with HP and it is also parallel to your VP. See, these two are parallel. So now these three conditions satisfied with the positions which we placed on the HP, right? Now we will draw it on the grid sheet. So first of all, I'll be drawing the XY reference line. So this is X, this is Y. Okay. See, whenever an angle or the one of its inclination happened with HP and it is parallel to VP. Okay, first, as we done in the last class, we have to draw first the simple position of the solid. Okay, now the solid is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. What you do is, so take the simple position as such a way that the axis is perpendicular to HP and it is lies on the HP plane. So that is the assumption which we are going to assume. Okay, so perpendicular to HP and rests on HP plane. So it means that I'm talking about the base. Then you draw the first top view of the cylinder. So it means that if it is kept in such a way, this. Okay. Sorry guys. Okay, now when you look at from the top view, so what shape we will get on the plane? Look at from the top view. So first we have to draw the top view whenever this kind of question is given. Guys, since they're given the base is 30 mm diameter, so even this is also 30 mm. Now tell me that when I look at top view, so what shape will I get? Guys, are you there? See, when you look at from the top view, first you'll encounter this shape, right?
So what is that?
Yes, circle. So you draw the first circle. So circle with 30 mm diameter. Okay. Right? So now you draw the axis. Okay. So this is 30 mm diameter. Okay. Now, in the last class, I have told that in prisms, the top surface will be denoted with one type of what special letters, and bottom will be represented with a different one. So what are those? See, the top surface will be represented by what and the bottom surface is represented by what? So recollect from the last class. So what we have done in the solids. Okay, I think you might have forgot. So top letter, top we have given the small letters A, B, C, right? In the bottom we have taken as 1, 2, 3, so on, right? So same thing we are following here. When you look at from the top view, only you can look at the A, B, C, D, right? Since this is the top view, which I'm going to draw on the vertical plane, right? So here first I will encounter A, B, C and D. Why? Because we are taking the X and Y axis of the cylinder. So it may be A, B, C, D, right? Now when you look at from the top view, below A, so there will be like behind A, we'll encounter point 1. So that will be representing how we are going to represent the hidden points. Guys, how do we represent the hidden points?
Numbers.
Yeah, numbers. But how?
In the bracket.
Yes, very good. So, bracket. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, another thing is, in order to get the smooth curve in the inclined positions of your cylinder, what we'll do is we will cut this circle as we done in the case of curves, right? In the curves we have divided the circle in 12 equal parts, right? Same way we are going to do here also. Okay, but we are not numbering that since we are not considering it as a exact solid edges. Okay, so with the help of your protractor or your compass, you cut the circle into 12 equal parts. So here already 1, so 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So it is each is 30 degree. Okay. Now you project all these points onto the axis XY reference line. Okay. So point A. So anyhow, these two points lie on the same line. So I will draw as a single. Point C. Okay, with this your simple position top view is finished, right? Now simple position front view. So when you look at front view, what shape you will get on the plane?
Rectangle.
So front view will be in which plane? Front view, which plane will get the front
VP.
View? VP. So already I have written here VP. So, but nobody told that. So here is your VP, here is your HP, right? Now they told that the axis height is 40 mm. So first you draw the axis 40 mm. Okay. So this is 40 mm height. 40. Now you join all the rest of lines. So A, now B. Okay. Similarly, all your projectors also. Okay. Now tell me how to represent the front view. So what will be on top surface and what will be on the bottom surface? You look at in this direction, or else you look at in this direction. So A will be where it will be, top or below? Guys, these things are important. Okay, so please remember where we are using the visible points, where we are using the hidden points, and where to how to represent the points in the front view and how to represent the points in the top view. So if you miss this representations, so definitely it tells that your diagram is not in correct position or whatever it may be. So I'll take here A, B, C, D in the this is in the quadrant. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now tell me, when you look at in this direction, where will be your ABCD locates, in the top or in the bottom? Okay, when you look at in this direction, see, so already I told that A, B, C, D alphabeticals will be represented in the top view. Okay, numericals, it means numbers will be located in the bottom surface. Okay, any solid you take, okay, or it may be for this kind of prisms. Okay, the notation will be in this way. Okay, so you should not forget. Now, so when I look at in this direction, see A is visible. So since A is in the top, so in the front view we have to represent it. In front of you, how we represent A dash or A double dash?
A dash.
Okay, very good. Okay, now when you look at in this direction, B is visible. B is behind D, so that the B dash is visible, and in bracket you have to represent D dash. Okay. Similarly, there is no point before C or there is no point behind C. Okay, then C dash you can represent as it is. Okay, now numbering is also in the similar way. Okay, now 1 is here, 1 dash, since this is front view. So 2 is first, 4 is behind your 2. So 2 dash bracket 4 dash. Now here 3 is 3 dash. Right, now this is the simple position drawing. So this is first top view, this is first front view. We have done this with the simple position. Now second one is tilt the front view with respect to the given condition. Okay, so what is the condition given in the question? Okay, they told that axis makes an angle 30 degrees to HP. Now this is the front view, so we got the axis, so we can easily tilt the diagram in the front view itself. Okay, in such a way we'll get this kind of position in the front view. Right, now you mark anywhere in the front view and you can locate it. So I will extend this. There it is. Okay. Now you draw an axis. Okay. So I'll bring back. Okay. In such a way, this angle is 30 degrees. Okay. Fine. Now, according to this, to draw the cylinder. Now, you know the distance from the center, right? This is the center line of your cylinder. You measure from the so almost it will be half of, because since this is the circle, you may get the values exactly like 15 and 15. So by placing your scale on this axis, then you get in such a way that 1 dash and 2 dash have same distance, and 2 dash and 3 dash should have same distance. Okay, so like that you plan accordingly. So I will be drawing that here. Okay, now draw similar like your first front view. Everything is similar to your front view. Okay. Now even the notations and the other lines also similar. So just draw the line. So you measure 1 dash and the next line distance. Similarly here. Okay. Now these lines, like these lines, okay, you just measure from the one dash, okay, for these two lines, for these two lines you measure from the three dash, and then you can draw the those two lines. Okay, so notations also similar to your front view. So here your A dash, B dash, D dash, here it is your C dash. Similarly, the bottom also, 1 dash, 2 dash, 4 dash, and 3 dash, right? So with this, your tilt position is over. Okay, see, if I project from here, like on the vertical plane, okay, I would get same picture. Okay, so here top and bottom. So you just join the top and bottom. See, we'll be able to get the rectangle in the vertical plane, right? So same thing, see, similar structure we got here also. So this is one verification you can have. Now the final view is you need to project the all the lines. Okay, how we have done in the last class. So from D you just project it horizontally. Again from this divided division lines. So from here you just project it. Again from this division, projected. Again from point C. Again from this division. Again from this division. And again from point B. Okay. Now similarly, you project this also onto the horizontal lines. Okay. Similarly, from 1, again from this small lines also, and again this division also, and draw your from center line. Okay. Again from your this 3 dash and this division, again from here. Okay. And similarly from the top surface, you need to project it on the bottom lines. So C dash, A dash. So almost all the points on the front view we have projected on the below XY, right? Now you just locate the common points on the these where the lines has intersected. Okay. So okay, 1 dash is in this line, okay. So 1 dash is here, and here your 1 dash is this line, right? So this is your common point. Okay. Now similarly your A dash. So A dash is here. First we'll project the first points, okay, numbers. Okay, so one is here. So two line is this. So two is in this line. So it is here. So here one suffix one, two suffix one. So four will be here. Four suffix one, and three in this line. So three will be the same line. It is somewhere here. Three suffix one. Similarly, you locate all the other points. So this line intersects this line. It is here, and another point is this point is here, and another point is here. Similarly, other points here, here, so here, 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 and here. Okay. Now you draw the alphabets. So A dash is here. So your A dash will be on this line. So your A is here, A suffix one. So B, so I think I have not drawn B. So projected B here. So your B will be here and here. So B dash is will be bottom, B suffix one. Hidden line is B. So here B one, B suffix one. C here in this line. So here your C suffix one. Similarly, you join other lines with points. Okay. See, when you look at from here, you can able to see the circle in the top view, like ellipse, whole thing you can see. So join with the thick line, this everything will be visible. Okay, so edges also we can able to see. So 4 dash and 0 D. Similarly, 2 dash and B. Okay. Similarly, bottom half you can able to see. Okay. So rest of the things it will be hidden lines. Okay. Now you draw the axis. Okay, so this is O1 here, it is center O2, right? So with this your drawing completes. So you need to give so already I have given first top view, first front view, this is second front view, second top view, and this is vertical plane, this is horizontal plane, right? So here the markings you have to give in this way, in this direction, here in this direction. So with this your first question gets complete. Guys, are you able to follow this question? Any doubts here? Similar way what we have done in the last class. Okay, there is no change in the position. Okay. One Hint is here, like in the angle. Okay, so here it is in this way, right? Here it is given in this diagram. Okay, so this is 30 degree and this is 90 degree they have given. So because those two are perpendicular, axis and your cylinder. So sum of angles is 180 degrees, right? So 90 plus 30 is 120. 180 minus 120 gives 60. So straight away you can take theta 60 degrees. So where we can take that? Here, okay, at point 3. You can take 60 degrees, then you can draw a straight line and then you can complete your cylinder or rectangle there. Okay, so if you find any difficulty in drawing, in other procedure, in this way you can draw. Okay. So any doubts here, guys? So I'll call any person randomly. So please, if you are able to complete, please show your drawings. So stop presenting. Okay. Srilekha. Srilekha, are you there? Okay, or else anybody, if you are willing to show your diagram, you can show. Okay, so you can just turn on your camera and you can present your drawing. Okay, those who are finished, they can raise the hand and they can present their drawings.
Sorry for interruption, Subhani sir. Can we go for a break and come back by 11?
Okay, sir, fine.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, guys, you can take for 15 minutes break. So now time is 10:45. So you can come at join at 11 o'clock. Okay, so those who want, you can complete and you can show after 15 minutes. So else, so me and Satya sir will be here. So if you have any doubts regarding your exercise, you can ask. Yeah, guys, you can take a break now for 15 minutes. So we'll come back at 11 o'clock. Okay, guys, I think the time is 11 o'clock. But still, people yet to join. We'll make 2 to 3 minutes for others to join in the class.
Yes, sir, we can wait for 2 to 3 minutes, then we can start the session.
Yes, sir.
Sir, we can start the session.
Okay, sir. Okay, guys, the next problem is draw the projection of a cone base 13 mm diameter and axis 50 mm long, resting on HP on a point of its base circle with axis making an angle of 45 degrees with HP and parallel to VP. So these two are similar problems. So just this is cylinder and this question is based on the cone. So rest of the procedure is similar to your first question. Okay, so you can also start drawing along with me. So if you have any doubt, you can cross check it. Okay. So, it takes 2 minutes, okay.
Sir, maybe you can restart the system if issues is persist.
No, sorry, I got it.
Got it, okay.
Yes, yes. Okay, guys. So, see, the procedure is similar to your the previous problem. Okay, so only instead of cylinder, we are just drawing the cone. Okay. So. Number two. Okay, so this they are given the cone. So I'll taking the simple figure. So your base diameter is 30 mm, and your axis height is 50. Okay, so this axis inclines 45 degrees to HP, okay, and parallel to VP, right? So I'll be considering any one point. So this is P, which lies on HP and inclined to your plane. So just I'll be drawing in the quadrant. So this is your XY reference line, your VP. Okay. So your cone axis is here. So this is your HP line, HP plane, This is 45 degrees. Okay. See, in this way, a point P somewhere here. Okay. In this way, the cone is inclined to your HP. So this is HP and parallel to your VP. So these two are parallel, right? Okay. Now we will draw it on your grid sheet. This is your XY reference line. Okay. So tell me, what is the first what you have to do to draw this first step? Guys, so what is the first step we need to do to draw this drawing? Which position we have to consider? Guys, can someone answer to this question? So which position we have to consider? Since the plane is inclined to, the axis is inclined to HP, so what we have to consider first?
Top view.
Ma? Yeah. I'm not able to hear you. Speak loudly.
Top view, sir.
Top view. I'm not asking top view. First, I'm asking the position of your directly we have to draw this position or what or how we have to proceed. So last problem, how we have proceed? The first we consider this simple position, right?
Yes, sir is asking where to start the problem. We should start with front view or top view. That's what sir is asking. And sir is also giving the instruction that wherever you are possible to see the true shape or simple solid, from that only you start supposed to start the diagram.
Okay. See in this direction directly we cannot able to see all your true shapes and true sizes, right? Okay. Since the axis of your cone is inclined to HP, so you consider any simple position which lies on the HP. Okay. So first we have to consider the simple position. Okay, since the angle is inclined to your HP plane, so you consider that first simple position is your axis is perpendicular to HP and your base rests on HP. So this is the first assumption. It means that how it look like. So if this is your so I'm extending the plane. Okay, so I'll be taking that. So our axis is perpendicular to your plane, HP plane. Okay, so it means that it is kept in such a way like this. Okay. Okay. Now, so I will consider one simple position is this is. First, I'll take simple position. Okay, where your axis is perpendicular to your base and it is on the HP. Okay. Now, in this simple position, when I look at from the top view, so what, how it will look like, or what is the shape of the top view of your cone? So we know that first we need to draw the top view. So top view we can get it on the HP, right? So this is my HP. So top view, which shape, which true shape I will get in the simple position of your cone?
Like point.
So you're telling this point, huh? See, this everything you can able to see, right? So this edges you can able to see, and even your slant heights, okay, that also you can able to see, and your point you can able to draw on the tower. Okay, why? Because see, since your cone is in the bottom, it is a circular shape, right? Okay, your cone bottom shape is circular. When you look at from the top view, first you can see the edges of your circle. Okay, then you can able to see your center point. Okay, these two you can able to see from the top view. Okay, that's why if you see any cone problem, your top view will be of circle, and your front view it will be of triangle. Okay, don't forget this. So first you draw a circle in the top view. This is the circle of diameter. How much? This 30 mm. Okay. Now you draw the axis. So this you can then draw with your compass. Okay. Now, so give the namings. A, B, C, D. So this is your O. So here it will be a O, right? Now you divide this cone as we have done earlier. Okay. If you want to draw a smooth curve, you can divide with same as usual. 12 equal number of parts as we have done earlier. Okay, but if you don't want waste your time, you can end up with the theta equal to 6. Okay, you can have 6 divisions or 8 divisions maybe. Okay, so 360. So how much? Or 45 you can take. Okay. So this you divide with your 45. So you take here 45, 1. Similarly, here. Similarly, here. Similarly, here. 45, 45, 9. In such a way, you can divide this. Okay. Now you project this on your reference line. So A and this division, so these two will lie on the same line. Okay, you need not to draw till end. D and your this divisions and your C. Okay. Now you draw the center line. Okay, so center line is your BD. Okay, which is from O. Okay. Okay, right. Now, as I told earlier, if you look at the cone from the front view, okay, you'll get the triangle. Okay. Now you join A and C to point O. Okay. So this distance is 50 mm. Okay. So this is your point O. You just join from A from C. Okay. Similarly, your other two division lines on those points. And this. Okay. Now you give the notations. So this is A dash. So if you look at from this view. Okay. So look at in this direction, B will be visible, D will be invisible. So here is B dash bracket D dash. So here your C dash, and top your O dash. So with this your simple position front view on top view we have drawn. Okay, now you convert or you tilt this front view simple position to the given condition. Okay, that's what we have done earlier also. Okay, tilt the front view of simple position to the given condition. That is 45 degrees to HP and parallel to VP. Okay. Now take any one point on the HP or reference line XY. So somewhere here. Now you draw a line 50 mm with 45 degree angle to this XY line. Or else you can do in the other way. So in the last problem I have told, right? So this is 45, this is 90, so this will be also 45 degrees. So this is sum of angles in a triangle. So that rule you can follow. So straight away you can take 45 degree and you can draw the line. So that is A dash, C dash, you can draw that straight away. Okay, if you are drawing with the axis, you can draw in this procedure also. Now you draw a line. Okay. So now you join to the O. So this angle is 45. Then you measure the distance from A dash to this division lines which you have drawn from the circuit. Okay, that you can join to the O dash. Similarly, from the other side also. Now you join or now you give the notations here O dash, A dash, B dash, and D dash. So here base is C dash. Now you draw the projections to the bottom, everything to the below XY line. So from D, again from this division point, again from C, again from this division, again from B. Similarly, from the front view also. A dash, this division line, this center line. Again, this division line, again, this C dash, again, here point O dash. Okay, now same procedure as we have done earlier. So connect all those dots. This is your A dash. So this is your A. So it means joint somewhere here, right? So your B dash D dash line is this. So B dash B matches here, and your D D dash matches here. So here A suffix 1, D suffix here, B suffix 1. And your C lies here, C1. Okay. So your point D somewhere, O dash. So your point O lies here. Now you join all the points. So you look at from this direction. Okay. So what can you able to see? O dash, A dash. Now you. Connect all these points. So D dash, C dash. See, this is invisible, your D dash and C dash. So this is in dotted line, and C dash B dash is also, you cannot see from this top view. So this is also hidden line. Okay, and your O1 D1 you can able to see, you join, and O1 B1 you can able to see, so you join. Okay. So this is your center of your base. Okay. So just draw the center line with the dotted. Right. So remove the unnecessary things. So this is your VP. So this is your first top view, first front view. This second front view, second top view. Okay. So with this, your drawing completes. Okay. And you have to mention your vertical plane and horizontal plane here. So if you look at from the top view in the quadrant, so this is how it look like. Okay, so with this your week 6 problems gets completed. So I hope that you have also in line with the today's drawings. So guys, do you have any doubt in this drawing? So I'll just call any random. So please, if someone has finished the first one, so they can present their drawings. So just to check whether you are following the class or not. That's it. So anyone is willing to present? Or if you have any class notebook. Okay, no problem. So I'll call random names. Shahil, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So where are you? What is the current status of your drawing?
Sir, I have drawn both, but not the cylinder and the triangle, the last step, sir.
Okay, no problem. Just show how much you have finished. That's enough.
Sir, I'm using desktop, sir.
Desktop.
Okay, yes, sir.
Fine. Okay. Sudarshan, Are you there? Srilekha, are you here? Srilekha? Okay, not here. Fatima?
Yes.
Shahin Fatima. Can you able to present your drawing?
No, sir, I've taken the rough notes kind, sir. It's not fad up.
Yeah, no problem. Even if it's rough, it's okay then. So if you're willing to show, you can.
Like, I didn't draw much, sir, so like, I just okay, took no so problem. That I can understand for the time being.
Okay, okay. So Birtana, are you here? Akshaya, are you here? Pawan Akhil. So I think so most of the people you are preparing for your CA maybe. So that's the reason or what? Guys? See, we have enough time to complete your drawing, okay? So please try to finish within this 3 hours. Okay, so later you can get free time, okay? You can prepare for your CIA. So no problem, I will be in the online. So please try to finish for the next 1 hour or 1.5 hour. So I'll be here. So if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Vijay CG, are you here? Sri Krishna. Kaushik Jairam. Nikita Sara. Ravi Partist Universe. I don't know what happened to these guys. Just they have been silenced or? Deepan. Okay, guys, I will be in the online. So if you have any doubts regarding your CIA syllabus or drawings, any doubts in your previously done drawings, so you can ask and you can discuss here. Or else, if you want to draw today drawings in the class time, so you are welcome to. So I'll be available up to 1 o'clock. So please utilize the time given for you. Okay.